Hi there, welcome back to my channel Scrap and Coffee. Are you ready to do some decorating? Because I know I am. This paper collection has been screaming my name ever since I started this project and I can finally start cutting into it. So let's get some decorating done. I have not really prepared this video, so we'll just see how it goes. I know there are some things that I want to tackle in this video, but yeah, we'll see. So where I'm going to start, I'm going to open it up and I'm going to work on the right hand side on the back cover where we still need to place down our waterfall. So I'm gonna go through my paper pad and I'm going to look for several things, but one of those things is a paper to cover this large piece here. So the other things that I'm going to look out for is, what do I want to use on the cover? I know this belly band is coming here with a large acetate window, so I'm going to keep my eye open for something that I can use on there as well. And keep in mind, if you're going to decorate on your own, that's of course totally fine, that you're not going to place layers or too much bulk on your front cover, because you're going to have that belly band have to slide over your front cover, right? So I have been going through the paper collection before, so I kind of know what I'm thinking of for the front cover. But I'm just going to go through it. Like, this would be a really fun element, but I'm thinking about another one. So this is what I'm looking at for the back cover where we are going to work on, and I think this one might be a good one for the front cover for the frame and do a really nice technique for the acetate frame there. Or what I'm also thinking for the front cover for that frame, at least, this is such a fun paper, is use this, but I think it's just a little bit too, it's not clustered enough to do it. So I'm thinking I'm going to use, where did it go, this paper for my front cover, and then I combine it with something. I think it's really easy to combine it with something, so I will keep my eye open for that. And then I'm going to use these two papers on the back cover where I'm going to work on right now, if I'm able to get this out. That's what I dislike about these kind of paper pads, actually. It's can be a pain to get them out of the paper bag. I don't want to rip this, right? Okay. So a couple of thumbs of rules that I use, and that doesn't mean that you have to do it, but what I'm going to measure my piece that I want to cover with this pattern paper. So I'm going to measure here 7 1/4 by 7 1/4. So you have to determine for yourself how much do you want to have your black showing on the outside when you're going to put your pattern paper on. What's used mostly is the 1/8 inch black border all around, or a 1/16 inch black border all around. And it's up to you to determine what is it that you like. I mostly use the 1/8 inch black border. Actually, to be quite honest with you, I go in between, but that makes it a little bit difficult, so let's not talk too much about that. But if you want to go a 1/16 inch border, which is like a really small border, right, it's something like this. I don't know how well you can see it, but it's really slight black border. And a 1/8 inch border is a little bit more than that. It's the double the amount. So I'm going to go for a 1/8 inch border. If you are going for the 1/16 inch border all around, you need to cut your pattern paper 1/8 inch smaller than the measurement that we just did. So that's 7 1/4 by 7 1/4. You're going to cut it to 7 1/8 inch by 7 1/8 inch. If you want to have the 1/8 inch border, you need to cut your paper 1/4 inch smaller. So 7 by 7. So that is what I'm gonna do with this paper. It's a calm paper, there is some pattern on there, but if you cover this up a little bit, it doesn't hurt me, right? It gives some interest, But it's not that I'm going to cover up all these beautiful flowers here, for example. So this is what I'm going to cut to 7 by 7. And you see that there is a little bit of a darker, the pattern is a little bit more here than here. So it's not really a directional paper. So I can also choose like, what is it that I want to use? Do I want to have the piece where there is a little bit more going on? Or do I want to have a piece there's not so much going on? Or do I want to have something in between? So I'm thinking I'm going to go for this part here, the right bottom corner. And I'm kind of thinking is how I'm going to do this with my paper trimmer. Maybe I need to put it somewhere where I can reach, but then you won't see me cutting the whole every piece, but I don't think you need it either, right? So I'm going to cut this down to 7, and I just have to keep in mind now that if I'm cutting it in this way, now this is not directional paper, so it doesn't harm me, but I can only use it in the horizontal way after this, if your paper is directional. So that's what you have to keep in mind with your first cut. I'm going to put this to the side and then cut this to 7 as well. And then what I like to do is I'm working here with a black base, and the paper has a white core, so you have a white edge. You can leave it just like this, but I don't like to see that white when I put it onto my black. So that's why I ink my edges. Like if I would put this on here and you flip it over, then you see that white edge. To finish it off, and those are the little details, I'm going to ink the edges or distress the edges a little bit. So for that I'm using the Tim Holtz Distress Ink black suit. You cannot see it anymore because I always put my inker on top. Just to go over those edges and take away that white core. And sometimes you want to do that a little bit more, and sometimes you want to be a little less, depending on the type of paper, depending on the feeling that you want to give to the project. So I'm not holding back, but I'm also not inking more on the paper on purpose. But you can do whatever you want to do with that. And that's for everything, right? With decorating, you can put your own touch to it. So there are a couple of rules that I apply for myself when I decorate, that I will share with you as best as I can. Maybe I forget sometimes of some things. But the most important thing is that you do you. You do what looks good to you and what feels good to you. Don't ever let anybody tell you that you're doing it wrong or it's not good enough, because it always is. It doesn't matter. As long as you're happy with it, it's all fine. So I'm going to glue this down right here with an even edge. So again, I can decide on where do I want to have that pattern come out a little bit more. So I often look in my camera because that helps me with seeing it from a different point of view. And it looks good in every single way, but I do know that I'm going to attach the waterfall here. So I don't want it there. I think I'm going to do this. Let's do this. So I'm going to use my art glitter glue to attach my pattern paper, but there are so many different things that you can use for this, like an ATG gun or your double-sided tape or your wet glue. It is whatever you prefer. I always go around the edge and then fill in the middle a little bit. The more you use, the more it will warp your paper. And you really don't need a lot of this stuff because it's really strong glue. What I will say about matting, and again, you do you, right? Of course, I have my personal opinions on what I think looks good and doesn't look good. But they might as well be very different from what other people think. And that's all good, because we all have our own style and our own taste of what we like, right? But I do hear people say sometimes, like if you have the paper packs from Echo Park or Cartabella, that they say like, it doesn't matter what you put together, so it's all gonna look good. Well, I don't agree with that part. Okay, I had a little interruption because they had to fix something on the roof, so we might get some background noise and I might have to take a recording break, but we'll see. You won't notice much of it, but I don't agree with the part where you can say like, if you have a paper collection, you can put any paper together, it doesn't matter. Why don't I agree with that? Because there are just certain things that visually works and don't work, like mixing patterns together. But I try to talk more about that during the decorating. But yeah, like I said, of course you just have to do what looks good to you and never let anybody tell you that you're doing it wrong or it's not good enough or whatever. Everything is okay, everything is good. As long as you are enjoying what you're doing and as long as you're happy with your project in the end, right? That's all that matters. So we need to attach our waterfall. That's my dryer. And I'm hearing all these sounds and I'm like, what's happening over in the house? But so for the waterfall, we need to line everything upright. So it's going to be somewhat tricky, but I already put the double-sided tape on here, right? I did that in the previous video. So what I will do with, to give me some wiggle time, is combine that with some with some glue. I'm getting totally distracted here. Okay, so I will put on some glue. Not too much, but just a little bit on that double-sided tape. Not everybody likes to do that, but I just need that because I know if I'm not gonna do it, I'm gonna be crooked. So I'm going to line it up with the cut edge on top. And I need to line it up with my flap here. So I'm going to close this flap and then align it where I'm not sticking anything down yet. Align it and then bring it to the cut edge as best as I can. So take your time on this. So we might hear some walking. Those are the people that are working on my roof. So let's hope it's not too bad. We had a little bit of a leakage problem. And they need to check it out. So I'm just going to burnish every layer of this waterfall here. So we just put that on top of our pattern paper, right? Okay, there we go. So the tree flaps are gonna go first, then the bottom flap, and then the top flap will go over that. That's how I'm gonna place it in here. So for the next step, I'm going to cut my pieces for this waterfall. And I am really looking at this. What did I do? I totally forgot. I make them 4 3/4, did I? All of them? I did. Oh, that's so smart of me. You know why? Because now we can place a photo here and a strip of pattern paper underneath it. And when everything is closed, you don't see the photo, but the pattern paper only. So I can already take that in account now that I'm choosing my pattern paper. I already decided on this paper, right? So I need to put something on here on the bottom. And I think that if we cut it to size in width, that we can make it out of that whole piece to do our whole waterfall. Is that true what I'm saying? We need 4 and we need 4.5. That makes 8.5 and then some half inch strips. So that should work perfectly. So let's do that. We cut it in to size in width. So this is 6.25. Remember, I'm going for the 1/8 inch border, so I'm cutting it 1/4 inch smaller to 6 inches, which is perfect because we just cut it in half. Okay, I had a little bit of trouble in making out the direction of this paper, but next up what I need to do is think about is, if I cut it here, do I want to have my pattern to continue, and then what is my best, the best where, what's the best place to start off cutting? So I think what I'm gonna do is right here. I'm gonna cut 1, 2, 3 half-inch strips and then cut this piece. So from the bottom. So let's get my other paper trim in. And then from the bottom, because I think that will give me the best result, is cut a half-inch strip. Am I saying that right? I think I might need a... I want to be sure. So if I do 4, what is it that I have left? Yes, half-inch strip will be fine. Yep. So half-inch strip. 1, 2, and one more. 3. So now I'm going to cut my piece where I stopped cutting for the top flap. So the top flap is 4 3/4, so I'm going to cut it to 4.5. So from here, 4.5. So this will be for that top flap. So I've cut it off of the bottom. And then from this piece, we can cut our piece for our bottom flap, which is 4.25, I believe. So that needs to be 4. So I'm going to decide, I think I like it best here on top. Okay, so this scrap piece is going to the side. And first I'm going to attach the part for the that we're going to see on top. So we just get that out of the way. I'm going to ink those edges and then glue them down. So when I'm deciding on, when I'm combining papers, things that I take in account are the different patterns, right? I really like to use solid papers. I'm really attracted to collections that either have solid papers in their collection or really close to solid papers with a really small pattern in there, or that I can get a solid, separate solid paper pack that coordinates with the collection, right? That's something that I use a lot, because I feel you need those solids or those more toned down papers to give your eyes a resting point in your album. And that also goes for using different papers on your layouts, on your pages. When I make decisions, when I have to combine like 3 different papers on one page, on one layout, I would go for something quite solid, combined with a large pattern. That's the steps that we have taken right now, right? I have a large pattern with something that is really close to solid. And if I need to add something to that, I would go for something that has a color scheme that I can find in one of the two papers. And that's where this pattern is really convenient, because it has that peachy pink and the little the touches of that green, sage green color. So it's easy to combine, but the pattern that I would choose would probably be something either, again, solid or close to solid, or small pattern. So you combine a large pattern with a smaller pattern and something solid, for example. So I would not combine 2 small patterns, because that will make it look cluttered. So you need to play with that. It's just like also in home decorations, and I'm not gonna try to tell you that I'm good at home decoration or anything, but they also apply those things, right? Some uneven things, and also like 1, 3, 5. So three different papers on a page work really well, but also size differences. So your eye will move around onto the elements. So that's what you want to create in here as well. We need to attach this pocket. Shall we do that first? Then we just have all our elements attached. We don't have to worry about it anymore. So without thinking about it, I actually did a pretty good job here with my flower. That's going to show through my acetate window here. So I need to think about, am I going to attach it? I can use the edge of my pattern paper to line it up, which would give me a nice amount of space between my top flap and the opening of my pocket. So that could work really well, actually. Maybe that's just the easiest way to go. You don't want to go to the folded edge of your bottom flap, because then you will get in trouble with opening up this flap. You need to stay away from that a little bit. And we need to even out our space. So this pocket was 4.5. This is 6.25. So 6.25 minus 4.5 is 1, 2, 3, 4. That's just how I do it sometimes. So 1.75 is what I have left. So I would have 7/8 of an inch on both sides, I guess. Let's see, 7/8 of an inch. So from the cut edge of my black flap, I would do that there. So really light, I'm making my mark really light, and I'm just going to see if that is the same thing here. Check your own calculations, right? But that's right, 7/8 of an inch. So I'm going to use my tiny tick mark there, and I'm going to use the bottom cut edge of my pattern paper to place this. So let's open this one up and place it there. Okay, I'm not gonna do tape here, because it will probably show through if I have the window through the window, and I don't want that. So I'm not gonna do tape. I'm just going to glue it on top of here. So you won't see me do this often, actually. I try to avoid it, but there we go. Just make sure that there's room between the flap and the pocket. Next up, what I'm going to do before I'm going to attach my half inch strips is cut some photo mats. You probably don't do that because you might put in your photo, or maybe you want to put pattern paper all over the flap. That's all fine. It's up to you. But I like to do the white photo mat here. So of course, I won't be bothering you with showing you how I do every single photo mat for this album. I'm going to prepare some later on, but just so we have some now. What I do is I get myself a sheet of 12x12. This is 65-pound weight cardstock. And I'm going to cut it in 3 strips of 4 inches. And I know I want to use different sizes photos in here. So 3 strips of 4 inches. And I make them to the photo size, right? I'm going to place them in there now. And when I want to put a photo in, I'm going to take them out. I would print my full-size photos with a white border. And I'm going to cut 1 strip. Again, to 4 inches. So I have 3 photo mats that are 4x4. Then I'm going to cut one. Or what I can do is cut 3 inches off. And again, 3 inches off. So that gives me 2 photo mats, 3x4 and 1 full size, 6x4. And I can cut one. And I'm just going to estimate the 6 inches here in half, and then I have 2 full-size photo mats. Well, we'll probably need a lot more than that, but this is what I do. And then I also like to doodle on my photo mat, so I'm going to prepare these 3 here. See if I have. I'm using this Pigma Micron in size number 5 this time. It's changed. It's not always the same size. Sometimes I use 2 or 3, whatever I can find. And my paper has a really smooth side and a rougher side. And my fineliner works better on the rougher side. So I'm just going to do a little doodle on here, because it makes my project look better. So I'm just going to make those doodles. So this doodle was inspired by Paul Fort, but it became my favorite one. It's the one that's going quick, it's easy, and it's the result is really great. So I'm doing a line. So here I've done three dots here, so I will start with three dots, do another line, one dot, draw my line, one dot, a line, three dots, and I just play with the length of the lines. I'm not really trying to be the same or something. It has to be a little bit playful. So again, three dots. And then I would also place a little camera stamp on there, and I always get a lot of questions about the stamp set that I use. But unfortunately, it's no longer available. But there are lots of places where you can find camera stamps these days. So you just have to do a little search on... try your local craft stores, I would say. Well, I have something on my acrylic block. So these are going to go on my waterfall, which will be in a landscape size. So that's how I'm going to stamp them. And that's my photo mat. So when I do large albums, you might realize that this is really time consuming. Okay, so the photo mats, I have opened up my waterfall and I'm going to place it. You have your score line here, so you're gonna go under your score line, and then I have my three strips here, and there is a pattern in here, and I want them to be in order, right? So let's see if I can get that in frame. So you need to make sure that they are in the right order. And I need the top one first. And you will probably notice with the half inch that we did, that we need to place them a little closer to the bottom cut edge of your waterfall flap. Which is fine, because when you close it, you will see more of the image and it will work better. And I kind of feel that I've done this completely wrong. But that's okay. What did I do wrong? I think I cut from the wrong side or something. Or should it be like this? Do I have it upside down? That's also perfectly possible. Should it be like that? Let's see. Ah, I think it should. Ooh, phew. Luckily I am paying attention here. Yes. So this is what it should be. Okay, so I had it upside down. So you need to figure out for yourself the amount of space that you have. So I have a good idea now. Let's place this under here so you can see my black edge. I'm going to ink this strip, which is always giving me really dirty fingers, inking up my fingers. But half inch, it's not too bad. The smaller the strip, the more messy it gets. Okay, so make sure that I have that in the right way. And apply some glue. So I like to go along the edge, but when I'm lazy or want to be quick, I just go whoop, scribble it on there. So make sure that your photo mat is not going over your score line. You're even out your border on the sides. And then place it. So here I will probably have about a 1/16 inch border on the bottom. So that is in place. And now I will get my removable glue stick. I use Scotch removable glue stick to place my photo mats. Nice and quick and effective. That's how I like it. So again, I'm going to align that with my pattern paper. I have a little bit of a black border between my pattern paper and my photo mat. And there we are. That's the first piece. Okay, the second one. So I have my letters on here from constructing. You might want to take them off or you just leave it. I'm gonna get my second strip of pattern paper. And ink it up. And again, I have to make sure that I'm going to glue this on in the right way. Like this, right? Yep. Okay, my other photo mat here. So here we have a folded edge. So you want to make sure for yourself that it's all gonna fit. And it's actually easier to start at the bottom flap so you can line out the pieces side to side. So I don't know why I started at the top flap, but that's what I did now. So just let's continue. See, now I'm just scribbling it on here. It's actually better to cover up your edges with glue. So I'm going to be messy here. Just make sure, now that I still have some wheel time, that I'm lined up with my pattern paper. I need to slide it slightly here. Okay, I'm happy with that. And then we can attach our photo mat here. So if you start on the bottom flap, which is way easier, then you just see there the pattern paper, right? You should see this paper when you close this flap and you're gonna apply your pattern paper here. You can just line it up visually with the strip underneath there. So I don't know why, but I started on top. Okay, so that's the second one. And now the last one. Ink it up. But it's also perfectly fine, right? If you want to place pattern paper all over and then put a photo on top, that's fine. Just keep in mind that your bulk will increase by quite a lot, because for every layer you're putting on a double layer of paper, because you're going to put your pattern paper and then a photo on top, it's really going to bulk up and you might not have enough space in your album. But again, it also really depends on the thickness of your pattern paper. But I don't advise on it. But I do understand that this is not a look for everybody, right? Not everybody likes this. Okay. I'm trying to remember to close up my glue in between. Okay. This one here. Try to make it straight. Okay, so this side of the waterfall is now done, but we are not done decorating because we need to figure out what we are going to do on this pocket and what is it that we are going to do on our top flaps. And you can also put a strip of pattern paper in between your half inch spaces. So those are some things that we need to figure out. And for that, we can use a combination of this paper with a third pattern paper if you want to. So we can go through the collection and see what it is that we can use, right? And what I'm thinking is on the top flaps, because it's something that I just do for variation in the album, I can do 2 3x4 photos next to each other. But what I do to have a nice black border in between is cut off 1/16 of an inch on the sides from both photo mats. So it's slightly cropped, but I have a nice even border. Okay, I'm going to see if there is something that we can combine this with, or are we just going to use the solid that we already have here. And we can also look for that little bit of green color, right? So I would not go for this. And there's nothing wrong with getting your papers that you already used close by to see how it combines. This is pretty paper. I want to save that. This is too pink. More flowers. This could work. This is a little bit of a, how do you call that again? It's a fabric texture feel. So this might be a really good option to combine it with. I like that. I'm trying not to linger on my decisions too long. Okay, so what is it that we are gonna need? I think I'm gonna do the pocket. So we need to do our frame. So if you haven't catched it yet, I do have another video on my YouTube channel. I uploaded it earlier this week, where I show you five different ways of tackling the pattern paper on your acetate windows. That might be a good video to watch and make a decision on what technique you want to use. I was actually kind of thinking about using the mitered. I hardly ever use it, but I was thinking about it. And then the faux miter or the actual miter. And then somewhere in the album, probably on the front cover, I'm going to do something like this. Okay, so what am I going to do that with this one? I think actually for this pocket, I'm going to use this one. It would just make it pop a little bit more, I guess. Yeah, because this is mainly white with that pink, so I think I'm going to do this one. Okay. Let's measure. So on my frames, I always go for a 1/16th of an inch border. Visually, that looks better to me. So this piece is 4.5. So I'm going to cut it 1/8 of an inch smaller to 4 3/8 by, this is 2.25 by 2 1/8. So 4 3/8 by 2 1/8. And I'm totally doing that wrong. Because I don't need a whole piece, I'm going to do that miter technique. So, what I need is 3 strips of 1/2 inch. 1. I think I can manage 2 out of this one. Let's see. 2 1/8 of an inch. So I need 3 strips by 1/2 inch, and then you need 2 strips 1/2 inch by 2 1/8 of an inch, and then 1 strip 1/2 inch by 4 3/8. So lately I've been doing a lot of my frames with the out of a whole sheet. So that's in my system at the moment. So I'm going to do the mitered look, not the faux one. You can do the faux one if you want to, because it's a lot easier. And if you make a mistake, it's not showing so much. Or actually it's not showing. But I need to make a 45 degree angle in this. So this is a 1/2 inch strip. So I'm going to mark 1/2 inch from my cut edge here on the side. 1/2 inch. 1/2 inch. And then I'm going to get my scissors. You could do this with your paper trimmer as well, but that's just too much fuss for me right now. I'm going to go from the bottom corner to my pencil mark. So if you want to see this, more options on how to do it, you can watch that other video. I will put a link on top. There we go. And this can go on the bottom. And then we also need to do that with our smaller strips. So on this one I'm gonna measure from the left hand side 1/2 inch and cut that angle. Like that. And then here I need to do it from the right hand side. Okay, let's see, what is it that we have? Okay, that's not too bad. So let's ink it. So I'm already thinking about what am I going to do here as well, because I wanted to go together, right? I'm not sure yet. I like a lot of cohesiveness in my album, so I would like to have this pattern or the pattern that I'm using here somewhere here as well. That doesn't always work out, right? But that's what I like, to have that, how do you say that? That transition of papers. And then there are people that absolutely don't want to do that, right? They don't want to see the same pattern on this page as they have there. So that's also an option. I feel by doing that, it gives me a lot of cohesiveness. And like I said, it tones everything down, all those patterns, and makes it a little bit easier on the eye. Okay, my son has his first day of school today. And I was invited to download an app on my phone so I can keep track of his day. Or actually, they are just sending me updates of his day, but they send me like an update every 10 minutes or so. It's a little bit crazy, but he's doing fine. So I'm going to place this where I have about a 1/16 inch border on the bottom and on the top, and even out my space on the sides. And then I'm going to glue these ones where I'm trying to bump up my strips, but I can see here already I'm not doing a great job there on my cut. So I'm just going to make it work as best as I can. So this is always, it's time consuming, but I always love the end result of those frames. So some things are a little bit quicker, some things like the techniques you can use on the frames, other things take some more time. And it's all about what looks good to you, what is what you want to do on these frames. Okay. So if this would bother you, the little mistake here, then I would definitely tell you to consider the faux miter, because that will take that out. Okay, so that's on there, and then we can take a look for a journal card in the collection to put in here. But first let's work on the rest of this here. So I'm kind of thinking in what is it that exactly that I want to do. So if I'm going to do the 3x4s, then I would need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So you can also do 2 3x4s, and then a full size photo here, 2 3x4s there, and a full size photo here. I think that's what I'm going to do. So I need 2 full size photos and 2 photomats 3x4. And then I cut down 1/16 of an inch from the sides of the, on the 3-inch side. So just a little hair. So you have that nice black border all around. And then we do a pattern paper here. And that might be from a piece of this. And then combine that with the third paper that we've chosen. And then we will have that paper come back here on the bottom flap as well. And maybe somewhere here as well. Okay, because I don't want to take you through making all these photo mats with me, I took the liberty of preparing some. And I'm going to glue them in place and then add our pattern paper. So what I need is 1, 2, 3, 4. So this has to be 2 inches if I want to do it out of this piece. It's just under. It's a hair under. So I might just cut off 1/2 inch from this piece here to work with that, because I'm thinking I'm going to do, yeah, and then the order of the pieces doesn't matter, right? Because you're not gonna see that pattern next to each other. So let's just see how far we get, and we try to get as much pattern in there as we can, but it's a large pattern, so you're gonna lose quite a lot. So it's just gonna give us a little bit of color. So I'm thinking I'm going to do one more from this, and then I'm going to cut the other 2 strips from the other piece. Because this is a little bit too boring for me to cut 1/2 inch off. So 1, 2. Okay. So I'm going to ink this strip. And also inking, it's time consuming, I know. If you don't have to ink your album or the pattern paper for your album, you'll be done in so much less time than when you are inking. But if I don't ink, I'm gonna totally regret it. So I am definitely inking. Some glue. And then I have a feeling that I've been here for quite some time, and all I have done is this waterfall element. But it's I'm not too slow, actually. I'm kind of I'm not unhappy with my working speed here. But I just know I'm a slow crafter. I know that, and that's one of the reasons that I don't film this, right? I find this extremely difficult to do. Just so you know. It's hard for me to talk through all of this because I am distracting myself, and I just need to make all these decisions and think about how I need to do it. And for some reason I always make mistakes if I'm filming, and I change my mind. So I try to be try to explain things to you, and then I change my mind, so I I'm all over the place. That's how it feels. So now that I'm placing these photo mats, I'm lining it up with the outside edge of the pattern paper strip. Line that up on both sides. And if I get my photos and I don't have a lot of photos to place 2 separate photos here, or I just have quite a lot of landscape style photos that I want to place here, I can easily change this out for a full-size landscape photo. I can change that out, change my mind. But now, this just gives a nice change of feeling, right? Some smaller photos, a larger photo, it just looks good visually, I feel. So here I will do the larger one with a strip of pattern paper. And again, it doesn't really matter which one, just pick one. But I might, because I have that large piece of white there, that I'm not gonna do this one. I'm going to combine this with 2 small photos, because there's not a lot of interesting things going on in this strip. So let's pick this one. Let's ink them all, so then we're just done with it, right? That's what I normally would do, but I don't want to spend too much time inking these pieces without something actually happening in the album. But then it's just done for now, because we need more strips, we're not completely done. Okay, so I'm also thinking about doing something fun on this bottom strip here, but we have to keep the bulk in mind, because it also has to function as the closure. But I think we can get away with it, but I will see when we're done with the top part of the waterfall. Okay, so So place it here. And I try to align it with the photo mat underneath, so you can use another photo mat or piece of paper that is the same width to see if you are aligned. And then place this one above it. Okay, and that's looking pretty good already. Flip over next one. So we already inked. So here I'm going to do two smaller ones. So here I'm going to use the strip that does not have that pop of color, not so much at least, to glue it all in place. Make sure that I'm not putting it too high on my piece. I'm going to place them here. You just don't, you take your score line or your folded line in account, right, with placing your paper. So again, this is a little trick that I do to make sure that it all lines up, at least as best as I can get it. And then put these photo mats there. So I'm not going to do any embellishing as of yet. I'm going to wait with that. I just want to get a main part covered with pattern paper before I'm going to do any embellishing. That's often the last thing that I do. But sometimes there is just something that you have seen and you know that you want to use it there. And then I will do it. But most of the time I will wait till the very last end. Okay, and then we need one more. So here maybe my best way to go is to place my photo mat down and align it with the photo mats that I can see on top. So I'm going to use the edges here to align it. And I'm just aiming for the same border, but I can replace this, right? So it doesn't really matter. Oh, I have room enough. I can even go a little lower. And then glue my strip of pattern paper down. So also here we can still place another photo if we want to, or a nice embellishment or something to make this a little bit more interesting. Okay, so that's all in place. Now I'm going to my third piece of pattern paper, and I need to cut that in to 6 inches as well. So I'm just going to cut it in half, and then we'll see. Maybe I'll regret it later. Maybe I won't. Okay, so it's cut in half, and then I'm going to need 1, 2, 3 strips of 1/2 inch. I say 1/2 inch, but that's not right. See, that's what I'm talking about. I need 3/8 of an inch. I'm not sure if I can do that. I'm just too bad. You need 3/8 of an inch strips for this, because you have 1/2 inch space. So you need to go a little smaller than your 1/2 inch. Okay, 3/8 inch strips. And that will fit in between your score lines perfectly. So that looks pretty good, right? I think it's a nice combination. So again, I'm gonna ink all this. Get my fingers dirty. So there, I don't really have a lot of rules that I apply when I'm decorating my albums. I just see what I think looks good, right? And But often that means that what I said before, that you are going to play with sizes of patterns. I like to be cohesive with colors, color combinations. I try not to do too much of different things on one layout or one page where different patterns are showing. Maybe I should do it, maybe I can do a little bit more sometimes, because there's also the risk of being too calm on your choices, right? And there's not enough interesting things showing and happening. That's the risk, right? So you need to find that balance, and that's actually the hard thing. You need to find the balance. And that balance can be different for me than for you. Okay, just stay in between the score lines and try to line it up here. But I see that my piece here is just a hair shorter than this piece here. And then here we have two fold lines, right? Where we need to be in between. So it's going to be a little bit deeper. Oh, slippery. That's there, one more, and then the waterfall is really done, the top part of the waterfall. I don't really put a lot of embellishments on the inside of the waterfall because I don't want to have too much bulk. But this, the way that we did the waterfall here, is giving you so much reducing in your bulk than when you have all your flaps separately. I really like that about this. Okay, there we go. And what you can also do is, if you do want to have a smaller photo here, you can also make this into a journal spot, right? Or you can use a 3x4 journal card or something. Don't forget about using those if you have them in the collection. They can be really handy to balance out the photos with the pattern paper, because that's another thing that you want to have balance in. There has to be enough photos compared to pattern paper and vice versa. So if you don't have, if you think like, oh, I like the idea of the small photos, but I don't have so much small photos, you can make this into a journal spot by using some white cardstock and just make some journal lines on it, or use your cut aparts from the collection. That's a really good idea to fill up those spaces as well. Okay, so what, I'm not sure what I'm gonna do here yet, but I'm going to have a look at our bulk here. At this moment we are totally fine with this. We don't have any gusset in this bottom flap, right? We could have done that, but I didn't want to do it because I already had a gusset here on this side. So I'm kind of thinking to do something here. I'm thinking of using this pattern to cover up the flap, and then use, like, I have this little scrap piece here. It's all too short for that way, right? Yep. So maybe we can do a small belly band here out of the pattern paper that allows us to tuck under another photo or journal card or something something. But that also gives a little bit more bulk, so keep that in mind. But I think I'm gonna do it. And then maybe I can find a flower in my, I have this booklet, right? With fuzzy cut items. So I'll probably look for a flower or something, maybe one of the cute animals to put on top of that belly band for a fun element. Yeah, I think we can make that work. So this piece I need to cut too. Where's my ruler? On the floor, why not? 4 inches, right? Because it's already 6, so I can cut a piece off 4 inches. So So that's one. So I need to make this piece 4 inches in length. And it's a totally crooked piece here. And I'm going to make it a little less wide. I don't know what we have right now. This is... I think I'm going to make it 3/4 of an inch. So try to get that straight. 3/4 of an inch. Okay. So this is not really popping, right? It's a little dull. So I'm going to change that by using a little bit of black. So go in your scraps. And I have a perfect piece here that I need to cut down to 4 inches. And then this is 3/4 of an inch, my pattern paper. So I want to have a little small edge on both sides. So I'm going to try 7/8 of an inch. And then see what I think about that. And that looks pretty good. So I have a little bit of a black border on both sides of that pattern paper. There we go. So I'm going to ink this. Not this, of course, but we do need to ink this. And first I'm going to glue this piece on my black. So that can dry a little bit. And now I'm going to glue this one down. So I have that fine tip on here, right? So I use really thin lines of glue. You really don't need a lot of it. Oh, let's even out that border. Okay, so I was doing it here, but you can also do it on this side. It's... what do we think looks better? It doesn't really matter, right? But I'm saying like right there. So in order to get it straight, I like to make a little tick mark, because for some reason if I don't, I'm gonna be completely off. So I'm gonna see from the cut edge of my pattern paper, I'm gonna go 1 1/4 inches in and mark that slightly. So let's do the same thing here on top. So if I align my piece with those pencil marks. Okay, that looks good. So getting some wet glue, I really advise you to do this with wet glue and not with double-sided tape. On the short side, on both sides, place a strip of wet glue. That's all we need. And then place it where you want it. And hold it in place so it can dry. So if you use a double-sided tape for this, that will always be sticky. So when you're going to put something under here, you have a chance of your photo mat catching onto that double-sided tape and get stuck there. And then maybe rip your photo or your photo mat when you take it out. When the glue dries, it's dry. It's not going to stick anymore. So it's not a risk to your whatever it is that you want to put under this belly band. So we can place something fun under here. So we can make some photo mats to do so. And we can still do this. So let's find a cut apart that we can place here, and maybe we also see something that we want to put there, or we make a 3x4 is our best way to go in here. Okay, so our cutter parts were all the way in the at the end. One sheet, right? Okay, so we have been doing quite a lot in these color tones, but I don't want to do too much. We can use this one, which has that background that we all used as our third pattern. So that would be a really good one to introduce that right at the beginning. And then maybe we can use this one to place behind the belly band. That could work. We'll see. Let's start with that one. So I'm going to cut the paper right here. Just cut the top strip off. You can also cut this apart and just have it ready if you want for one using it. Okay, so I have that one cut out. And now I'm going in my drawer with scraps. I have a lot of these sort of scraps, which are probably the perfect size to cut down a photo mat. I'm going to cut my photo mat. I need to think, do I want to have it like this? And you can also make it with a little bit of a white border to give it a little bit of extra interest and pop. But then I would cut this one down. But to be quite honest, my font is pretty close to the top edge, and the foot of the raccoon ears actually right at the bottom. So I don't really want to cut this down any further. I don't really have to, I see. It's a little bit under 3 inches. Yes, it's three. Sorry, it's a little bit under 4. It's 3 7/8 by 3. But I can cut it down on the side slightly. I'm really close to the tail here. I'm pretty close to the font there. Okay, I don't think I'm gonna do the white because I don't want to cut too much in this card here. But you can absolutely do that. So you need to decide on the border that you want to have on your black. So I'm gonna go for a 1/8 inch border. Now I know it's a little bit, it's 3 7/8 and not 4. So I'm going to cut mine 4 1/8 by 3 1/4. Okay, I can bring that down a little bit. So I just look like, how do I like this border? But I can bring it down a little bit. That's better to me. Okay, I'm going to ink it. And I'm still in doubt what I'm going to do with this. If I'm going to give it some white or not, actually. I feel like it looks better. But again, it gives more bulk, right? Just keep it in mind, it gives more bulk. See, and this is what happens to me. I'm not able to make a decent decision. It just looks better with the white. So I can also just get myself a 4x4 because it fits on a 4, right? And just cut it a little over 3. Okay, I did 3 1/8. Let's see. Okay, that's fine. And then I will cut myself a new piece of that black. Maybe I did it too small. We'll see. Okay, that will work. This will work. Yeah, I just like that better. So when I'm going to do all this layering, I like to work with some double-sided tape as well. It always makes it a little bit hard for me to be straight. But I have really small 1/8 inch tape that I'm going to put around the perimeter of my pattern paper cut apart. Fill in the middle a little bit. And I'm going to stick this, hopefully, straight on the white. So remove my tape backing. Okay. Okay, I'm just hovering above it, and then when I think I have a nice even border, I will place it down. And then this I'm gonna glue with my wet glue on top of the black. So I don't layer too much with the wet glue, because it will warp your paper if you do that. So try to hold back with the glue. Just make sure that you have your edges covered. And fill in the middle a little bit so it doesn't pull on the edges. And if you burnish it, then you will smooth out that glue behind it as well a little bit, right? If you don't do it, and your glue is gonna dry, and you put those strips of glue like I do, so you're gonna scribble over it, and you don't burnish it and even out the glue, you have a slight chance of seeing those that movement of glue behind your paper. Not looking very pretty. Okay, so now we have this. You can place a photo on the back here, right? Or some journaling. I'm just gonna leave it black for now. So we can place this in here, and I believe that a full-size photo with a photo mat will also fit here. So maybe we can do a combination of the two, and I will show you how you can make black photo mats to go behind your full-size photos out of your 12x12 paper, how you can make 4 out of 1 sheet of 12x12. So in order to take 4 photo mats out of 1 sheet of 12x12 paper, we're going to use the pinwheel technique, and for that I need this trimmer here, where I can read my measurements on top and on the side, and where I can easily read where I start and stop cutting. So I'm going to cut 4 pieces 7 by 5 inches out of this 12x12 piece, and the combination of your piece, the length and the width of your piece together has to make 12. So I'm doing 7 by 5. 7 plus 5 makes 12, right? You could also do 6 by 6, or you could do in between, like 5.5 by 6.5. So that's those are options, as long as they together form 12 inches. I'm going to line up here my piece with the 7-inch mark here. And I'm going to bring my little blade up to my 7-inch mark here on the side, so I can use this thing here to line it up. I'm going to push it in the cardstock, and I'm going to cut up. I'm going to turn my piece counterclockwise. Again, line it up with 7. Start cutting at the 7. Cut up, and this is my first photo mat. Well, I need to cut it down a little bit more, but again, line it up with the 7 and start cutting at 7. And cut up, and then we have 2. And we do that one more time. Turn counterclockwise and now go all the way to the bottom. Cut up, and you have 2 more. And this is your little scrap piece. So by using that pinwheel technique, you can get 4 large pieces out of 1 sheet of 12x12. But this is of course too big for my 6x4 photo. So I'm going to use my larger trimmer to cut it to size that I want now. So it takes a few extra steps, but it will save you on cardstock if you don't have scraps for these large photo mats. So my paper trimmer, I don't really like the way it cuts. I have 2 nice sharp edges and 2 rougher edges where I've cut with my paper trimmer. And I'm going to keep my eye on those, then I'm going to cut them off with this paper trimmer. So lengthwise, I'm going to cut them to 6.25. That is what you would do for a 1/8-inch border, right? With a 6x4 photo. But often, I feel that that's just a little bit too much of a border. I like it to be a little bit smaller. So what do? And I don't think I've ever shared this before, but I just go 1 tick mark underneath it. Cut it 1/16 of an inch smaller than that 6.25. And then I turn it. Here is my rough edge. And do the same thing here. So I'm going that tick mark under 4.25. And then I just enjoy the amount of black border that I have all around way more. It's way more balanced to me personally. So you could do 6¼ by 4¼, that's totally fine. Or you can do just that here under. And then I have two more of these scrap pieces, right? So it might feel like you have a lot of scrap pieces by doing this. But if you do it in another way, you can only get 3 pieces out of your 12 by 12. So it's up to you how you want to do it. This is just, it takes a few more steps, but if I know that I'm going to need a lot, I would just cut me a few sheets of 12 by 12 in the pinwheel and then cut them to my sizes for the photo mats. That is if I don't have scraps for them, right? If I can have scraps, then that's my first choice, right? But these are quite large pieces that you need. And you don't always have that in your scraps. Or maybe you have it for 1 or 2. I have 4 prepared now. So, where is it? The full size one? Right here. And this one. So I'm going to just glue it down. Let's feel. Yep. A little bit further. And then try to even out my black border here. And let's quickly do my doodle, which is far from perfect, but I like it that way. Which is a really good excuse to say, yeah, I know it's not perfect, but it's intended. Uh-huh. No, just kidding. I don't really try to be perfect here. I never do. I never try to be perfect with them. So, then we have this. And we can place this together in our pocket. And our waterfall will stay in place. So I think I'm going to do just a photo here for now. But I also have to figure out what I want to do here. So I'm going to place myself a photo mat that I have not completed yet. It's not finished. But I just have it there so I know that I still need to do that. And we can also think about what we want to do here. But for now, I feel that I have been filming quite some time now. So I think we're going to stop it here for now, and if I have time to film a little bit more decorating then before Friday, then I will upload it before Friday. But I also have some other things that I want to finish, so we'll see when the next video will be there. So I hope you enjoy this. At some point we can go quicker, right? Because I don't have to explain every single thing anymore. But yeah, I try to give some information as well in these videos. So I know it's probably been a long video and we don't get very far, but that's how it goes with me and decorating an album. So I like what I see at this point. I hope you do too. Thank you for watching and enjoy the rest of your day. And I hope to see you in the next part. Bye bye.